So the last talk before the coffee break is by Dr. Somlyai, and he's going to talk about the effects of administration local application of deuterium-depleted water on dogs and cats suffering from spontaneous malignancies.
Ladies and gentlemen, so I have to say that most of the work, 99% of this work, was carried out by Sabo Marian, who is a vet, and she was one of the most active vet in the last 10 years who collected and he treated lots of cats and dogs, and I will show the results that is carried from her work. So the very first cat we treated, it was 15 years ago, and it was a 9-year-old cat with leukosis in a very, very late stage. The cat couldn't eat and couldn't drink, so her weight was 4 kilograms. And at the beginning, we have to inject a couple of milliliters of deuterium-depleted water, but we saw after a couple of weeks that the cat improved, and 6 months later, the pathologist couldn't confirm the leukosis. And the point is, I was very surprised when someone called me that cat was 22 years old a couple of years ago. So we can think about anti-aging. After that, with Tamás Berkényi, we treated different animals, and I collected a couple of dogs which had a breast cancer. That was the very first dog with breast cancer, 10 times 6 centimeter, and 9 months later it was 3 times 2 centimeter. Here we couldn't see the regression of the primary tumor, but the metastasis disappeared. Here there was a complete response, and we treated several animals, and we collected the results. And the final conclusion was that in 1999 we've got a registered drug for veterinary use. So we were very happy to have a drug at least for dogs and cats. And this is on the market for over 10 years, and I will show a couple of summary about this reason. But I also would like to show some kinetic. We used dogs and cats, and we gave them water with 30 ppm, and every third week we took a blood sample and we measured the deconcentration. And this is one example for a dog which consumed exclusively deuterium-depleted water, and you could see that the longer they consume, when we add back the normal water, the deuterium level went up. And here is an example for with a cat. It also happened the same way. Okay. If we would like to summarize the results of the last 10 years, here is a couple of tables. So here is dogs and cats with breast cancer, and we could say that roughly 50% we could get a complete response. 11% alone, the DDW consumption resulted a complete response, but of course, when there was a good response and the tumor size decreased, it was suggested to operate and remove the rest of the tumor. So this is the combination of the surgery and deuterium-depleted water. In roughly 20%, we could get a partial response either by surgery combined with DDW or alone. No change were in 13% was the progression of disease. And if you see the results in the rectum tumor, we could see roughly almost the same ratio. We could say 50, 70, 80% of these animals responded extremely well. And with leukosis cat, we have the same results, and we couldn't see any results with the dogs having leukosis. Besides these, we have some other animals with not a big number, bladder, liver, pancreas, and lung cancer, and we could see that these type of tumor also responded quite well. On the other hand, when we checked animals with sarcomatoid tumors, we didn't see that good response. So it was evident that we could extend the life expectancy of these animals, we could slow down the progression of the disease, but we couldn't say, okay, we could cure or we could get a complete response. So one of the questions which can raise whether we can increase the efficacy of deuterium-depleted water. Because in all cases we used esaperos, so the normal water, drinking water, was replaced with deuterium-depleted water. Here is some other tumor types. We couldn't get so good results. So, and the question is, if, as I showed, that when an animal starts to consume deuterium-depleted water, there is a gradual decrease in the body, which could be 1, 2, 3, 5 ppm per day, and there is an equilibrium, and when it changes after that. So the question was, when we didn't get good response, whether it's due to the low dosage, and if it can increase and we can get a sharper decrease in deconcentration, whether it can modify and enhance our efficacy. So the thing, we decided to prepare a physical salt solution with a 25 ppm deuterium, and we have an equipment which is a needle-free injection. It means that we can push the physical salt solution into the intracellular space by using a high pressure. And now, a couple of slides, you will see how effective can be the deuterium depletion. This is a breast cancer without treatment, before the treatment with DDW, and you can see the tumor is growing down and infiltrate the area. And we applied the DDW locally, we could see that the tumor was rejected from the body, and the tumor was sitting on a stalk after 5 weeks. This is a control animals. These animals had a breast cancer. The breast cancer started to grow, and after a couple of weeks, these animals died. That dog wasn't treated with deuterium-depleted water. So this is a normal way how a tumor developed and killed the animal. This series, another tumor, the tumor is on the eyelid of the dog. Here you can see also there is some stalk, and the tumor is coming out from the body, and it can increase the operability, and it's very easy to remove the rest of the tumor. The next slide shows another tumor on the auricle of the animal. Here's a tumor, 4 weeks treatment, 8 weeks treatment, 16 weeks, 24 weeks treatment, there is a huge regression. And I can show you again a control animals which hadn't been treated with deuterium-depleted water, so the tumor destroyed the whole part of this auricle. Another example, again, rectum tumor, the size was so big, locally injected, causing a big decrease in deconcentration. There was a gradual decrease in the tumor size. And this is my favorite. That dog was diagnosed with hemangiosarcoma on the neck, and that dog received the chemotherapy and radiotherapy, and that time they wanted to kill the animals, saying, okay, this is the end of the story. So we could get the animals, and Marian started the treatment. Here you can see that the necrotized part of the tumor disappeared, and 10 weeks later there is a good big recession, and 14 weeks later even regressed, and later the tumor completely gone. So finally, these animals are still alive after 2 or 3 years after the treatment. This is a rectal tumor. The tumor disappeared. And here I only would like to show what we have done with the other animals also. So we took the samples regularly after a couple of weeks of treatment, and we asked the pathology to analyze on cell level. So before we started the treatment, the pathologist says this is an adenocarcinoma. After 4 weeks, it was said it's an apocrine adenoma, which means there was a shift from malignus to benignus. And after 8 weeks, no tumor cells were found. That was a heavy lymphoid infiltration, which is part of this curing process, as the immune system goes there and eliminate the necrotized cells. This is another, just a sample. There was a melanoma, and you could see that no real border in the skin, because everywhere you can find malignant melanoma. And after the local treatment, we could see the borderline of the dermis, and it was pushed, this melanoma cell, into a certain area. The other good point when we use deuterium-depleted water, that, as I mentioned, that we can improve the operability of these tumorous animals, because the shape of the tumor is getting regular, and it's much easier to operate these type of tumors. And that would be the future. So what we think about the future, how can we treat animals? So this is an equipment which is good to use a high pressure and infiltrate the low D concentration into the tumor and the surrounding area. You will not hear it, but it takes a couple of minutes. So that dog has a very huge tumor, and our aim is to infiltrate the tumor and the surrounding area with deuterium-depleted physical salt solution, so locally can decrease very sharply the deconcentration, and that will trigger all the mechanisms which finally can lead to complete tumor regression. The big if you talk about what would be the best treatment, we could say that if the animal is consuming deuterium-depleted water before surgery, that can help, and that make easier to operate the rest of the tumor. If the animals got the complete remission and no any other tumor, we suggest to continue the Paris treatment just to prevent any metastasis, and we also suggest that every year it is recommended to make a cure and give the animals for 1-2 months deuterium-depleted water. And as we go further, and we can maybe repeat it only once a year. So if we summarize our results, we could say that the Paris administration of DDW, the range is 25-85 ppm, can cause a partial or complete tumor regression in dogs and cats. We found that the sarcomate tumors proved to be very resistant to the Paris administration. But with the local application and using that stereophysical salt solution, we can induce in the resistant and the more aggressive tumor type that we could get a regression. And this is a real big challenge and a big question mark, that when animals we are treating with Paros, we suggest to replace all the daily water intake with deuterium-depleted water. And in the case when we use the local treatment, it was enough to inject twice a week. So it means that somehow maybe two different processes induced. In one case, we can get a gradual increase and we keep it for a very long period of time, and that is could be enough to cause a complete tumor regression. In the second case, when we use locally, within short period of time, we can get a huge decrease in deconcentration, and we are sure that after a while, there is the ppm will go up in the tumor, but somehow that deep decrease in the deconcentration triggers certain mechanisms in the tumor cells, which finally can cause and result complete tumor regression. And of course, we say that maybe how to combine them, what is the best way to combine these techniques. It's require further research and lots of other work to complete. And that would be also which I have mentioned, that so it's a typical phenomenon that somehow the depletion push all the structure and histology picture, and maybe the biochemical pattern of the cell from malignus to benignus, and that can somehow change the whole process in the cell. This is what I wanted to tell you. Thanks to Sabo Maria and all the other vets. Thank you.
Any questions from the audience? I would have a question, and so when you apply the product dermally or topically, then this differentiation of tumors, that would be the course of recovery eventually if, obviously, if this would be applied in a clinical study type of basis, because these are, I would assume these are anecdotal cases or individual treatments of animals. How many responded the same way as the one that you showed here?
So before we apply for the drug application, we filed it. We carried out a well-controlled protocol. There was a protocol, and according to the protocol, we treated the animals. The Paris application, we could say that 70-80% respond quite well to deuterium depletion. When we go to the local application, we could say it could be 80-90%. So the rare is when we cannot see the clear effect of deuterium depletion. And so we could say it's almost...
Is there any information of with regard of how low you can go with topical or dermal application? Because if you orally apply it, I believe there's no way they're going below 80 ppm. How about...
So when Marian use it, so we are going to use roughly the same volume as the tumor volume. And so it could be from 5-10 cubic centimeter to 20 or even higher. It means that if we look at the mass ratio of the tumor and the water, we can say that the equilibrium about the halfway. So I temporarily from 150 ppm using DDW with 25 ppm, we can bring it down locally to 90 or 100 ppm. This is how we can estimate based upon other kinetic investigation.
Alrighty. Any questions from the audience? Go ahead.
Thank you. It's more than a congratulation than question, because I'm a very big animal lover. I have two cats and a dog at home, and I, at least for them, maybe it's going to be, they're good news.
I have two dogs.
Yeah. Well, so that's good news.
I have two cats.
Okay. Yeah.
Okay. Anybody else in the audience?
Right. No, I wanted to ask you, have you asked an oncologist about this conversion of the tumor? I've never heard about it in humans. So a therapeutically conversion towards something benign. Have you asked somebody about this? How could it happen?
So what I know that those guy who made for us that pathology, he is one of the best Hungarian pathologists. Mm-hmm. And this is the reason we ask him to do that. I don't believe that he could explain it. Mm-hmm. He only could say, okay, this is what he saw.
No, because in humans, it never happens. So when you so-called cure a cancer, you're able to remove it, but not to turn it into something benign, which might be possible in animals. I've seen situations with necrotic tumors which just simply fell off of animals. But in humans, it never happens.
Okay, well,
so I don't know.
Wait for the end of this Symposium.
Okay. Yeah. Okay. Thank you.